Buenos días, damas y caballeros. That's the wrong language. Bonjour, bonjour, ladies and genitals. My, I got the video for you. Because today, folks, I want to talk about Pulse Chain. I want to talk about Hex. And I want to talk about what could be the biggest airdrop in history. So, if you like the sound of that, and if you want to learn more about this, and potentially how to participate, like and subscribe, hit that bell icon to be notified of new uploads. Let's delve into it. So, folks, welcome to another episode of A Million to the Moon. In this video, I want to talk to you guys about Pulse Chain and Hex. What is Pulse Chain? What is Hex? So, some of you may know, some of you may not know, just to kind of briefly summarize what these projects are all about. Number one, Richard Hart. He's a very famous crypto person. He's a founder of Hex. Hex is a very popular cryptocurrency that has been doing absolutely amazing as of late. Now, while we could delve into Hex a lot more in kind of some of the controversy behind Hex, I don't want Hex to be the focus. In fact, I want the focus to be about Pulse Chain. But before we talk about Pulse Chain, I kind of want to let you guys know what this whole situation about, what Richard Hart's about. So now that you guys know that Richard Hart is the founder of Hex, let's talk about Pulse Chain. Because folks, Richard Hart is back at it again, wanting to create a new project called Pulse Chain, which is a fork of Ethereum with lower block sizes, faster transaction times. It is also a deflationary mechanism. It's proof of stake. So essentially, Richard Hart is trying to create, well, he is creating a fork of Ethereum, a better version of Ethereum. And this project is coming out in the near future. So folks, the rich billionaire vampire looking dude wants to create a better version of Ethereum. How do you participate? Well, number one, do your own research. I'll leave a link down in the description below so you guys can check out the website and you guys can read all about it yourself. So the way this works is that you go to the website, you go to OpenDApp, it'll take you to this page here. You connect your MetaMask wallet, and the way this works is that you'll have a selection of either ERC-20s or tokens on other blockchains that you can basically send your crypto to an unknown address, and then you'll get points in return for sending your cryptocurrency to an unknown address. And then later on, those points may or may not end up getting you airdropped Pulse tokens. And again, guys, Pulse is basically Ethereum. Think of, you know, Pulse Chain as literally Ethereum. Like, you know, Bitcoin Cash is Bitcoin, Pulse Chain to Ethereum. Think of it that way. So again, guys, if you want to participate, go to the website, OpenDApp. It'll take you to this webpage here. Connect your wallet. You select your network. And it'll tell you an address to donate to, which is this one here. Please follow the official contract address from the website. The number two way to participate is by going to the website, clicking on this link. It'll take you to this webpage where you can choose to send your cryptocurrencies to the SINS Research Foundation, which is a medical research charity, and you'll get these points that can later lead to a Pulse Chain airdrop. So those are the two ways to participate. Either you sacrifice your coins to this address that nobody knows who's in control of as a political statement, or you can donate to charity. So folks, if you're skeptical about Richard, if you're skeptical about Hex and things in the past, but if you're curious about Pulse Chain, I mean, worst case scenario, you can send your cryptocurrency to this, you know, medical research organization, and worst case scenario, you just donated to charity. So guys, if you're curious about Pulse Chain, I invite you to, you know, donate to this charity, and you know, you'll get points and then maybe airdrop Pulse Chain later on. If you think Richard is a scammer and this is all a scam, as some people do criticize Richard as a scammer, I don't think he is one, but there is that criticism. Well, if you're curious, want to participate, do it through SINS Research. Worst case scenario, you just end up donating charity. So those are the two ways. Please follow all the instructions on the website. So guys, the interesting thing about this is not only is Richard Hart creating a fork of Ethereum that you can be airdropped this new token through donating to charity or sacrificing your tokens, your coins to an address that people don't know who is in control of. But once mainnet goes live, you'll actually be able to get a copy of your existing ERC-20s on the Pulse Chain network. So let me try and reiterate that in a way that maybe makes things more clear. Once Pulse Chain goes live, there will be a way to create a copy of the coins you have on the Ethereum network to the Pulse Chain network, essentially doubling your holdings. And who knows, folks? Like, imagine if you have, you know, Chainlink in your MetaMask, Cardano in your MetaMask, or I don't think you can hold Cardano in your MetaMask, but let's say Chainlink, for example, some other ERC-20. Well, once Pulse Chain goes live and more details are released on how you'll be able to get airdropped existing ERC-20s on Pulse Chain, a lot of people will essentially be able to double their holdings, because almost every ERC-20 existing on Ethereum will be duplicated on the Pulse Chain network. So folks, super, super interesting. Who knows what Pulse Chain could be worth? One thing Richard Hart is doing, well, Richard Hart is doing a few things to avoid having this thing being labeled a security. Number one, he states very clearly that you should have no expectations of profits from sacrificing your cryptocurrencies to these addresses, okay? You're just doing this as a political statement, okay? And later on, you'll be airdropped Pulse Chain tokens, but this is all in an effort to not be labeled a security. Another thing, when Pulse Chain drops, Richard Hart is hoping to have this thing be valued at zero. So once you get airdropped Pulse Chain, it will not be listed anywhere and will be therefore valued at zero. But once this thing goes live, since it's essentially a fork of Ethereum, a better version of Ethereum, who knows what the price could be? Could it be the same price as Ethereum? Could it be a similar price as Ethereum? Could Pulse Chain end up being like the, you know, Bitcoin Cash to Bitcoin? You know, Pulse Chain to Ethereum, Bitcoin Cash to Bitcoin? Who knows? We'll see. But I think this is a super, super interesting opportunity. Very interesting. The fact that not only will people get airdropped this Pulse Chain token that may be worth something like Ethereum one day. Who knows? You'll be able to copy existing ERC-20s on the Ethereum network to the Pulse Chain network. Super, super interesting. So guys, as more details come out on the Pulse Chain airdrop and how to get airdrops of existing ERC-20s on the Ethereum network to the Pulse Chain network, we'll let you guys know as more details come out. So folks, like and subscribe. I have participated in this thing myself, for the sake of full disclosure. And until next time, folks, take care.